Hello everyone, another RBMK reactor video here. In this one I will be doing something a bit similar to what I did in the previous video, in which I disconnected MCPs to see if I was able to increase reactivity by boiling. In this one I will simulate a situation in which a new operator comes to work to this nuclear power plant and he's in charge of the operation of this reactor and he doesn't really know what are the particular aspects of graphite moderated reactor. So it's like a worker that previously had experience in a water moderated reactor and now he just operates a graphite moderated reactor without knowing what are the differences. So if you see the panels here, you will already realize that we are a bit critical, because if you look at the position of the control rods, they are at 5.1%, all of them, and the remaining fuel is 32%. So this is at the edge. This almost in the very similar situation at which reactor 4 of Chernobyl was put in before the accident in 1986. So because we have so many rods outside the reactor, we are at the edge of controllability because of these graphite tips that actually have the contrary effect of what the absorber rod should have. So now this 5.1% of control rod that is actually inserted, this is entirely graphite. So you may say if it's entirely graphite, this control rod will have the opposite effect on reactivity. Actually no, because even if there is a physical boundary for the reactor, the boron that is outside the reactor is still capturing neutrons. So the reactor is not like a binary thing which either you act pro or against it. If you are in the vicinity of a reaction because there are neutrons going everywhere, you are already affecting this reaction. It's like magnetism or gravity or anything related. It's a field, it's not a binary thing. So even if you only have graphite physically inside the boundary of the reactor, these control rods still have some controllability by the proximity of the boron, which are still inside the reflectors, which are graphite made. But we are really at the edge. I think the edge is around 4.9%. I don't know exactly. It depends on xenon concentration, boiling and other things. But I think in the configuration we are now, just 0.2-0.3% withdrawal of rods will mean loss of controllability. So it means a drop of neutron rate to zero in really fast, like few seconds. And then the reactor is stalled because there is no way to bring the reactivity back. So what I did in this edge situation is to fix everything using cheat engines. So now there is no fuel burn up. So we are at nominal power, almost at 99.5% of neutron flux, but everything is stable because I fixed xenon and fuel burn up using cheat engine. You see everything is selected, so everything is fixed. So now imagine you are this new worker of the power plant that you only have experience with the water moderated reactors. So he realizes, oh my god, I'm at the edge of controllability. The fuel is just 32%, so I need to do something to avoid stalling the reactor. Of course, there is no time to refuel in this condition because refueling will take time. So the first thing he does is to say, okay, so if fuel burn up is caused by power or by neutron activity, then the first thing he must do is to decrease power, so he will have some extra time to do something. Okay, so let's decrease power. So he starts decreasing in steps of 5%. I just click this arrow here, so we see the dip in the neutron rate. I will continue decreasing. So here the worker thinks, okay, if I decrease power like at 20%, this will burn fuel at 1/5 of the normal burn up speed. It will give me time to refuel and then I will not stall the reactor. So he keeps decreasing. Okay, I forgot to tell you before, but the voiding was at 20% before I started decreasing. Now it's already at 16%. And people with experience with RBMKs may already see where this is going. So I keep decreasing power set point. 80% now. I will just increase half point so we're in round numbers. And we need to check like all the auxiliaries and everything if it's okay while we decrease temperature. So turbine is critical at very high power changes. But you see the rotor now, it's not very cold. It's just 10 degrees below the shell, so it's still okay. We can keep decreasing. 75. Also check reactor level. Of course, a decrease in boiling causes an immediate decrease in reactor level because the level is made up with water and bubbles from boiling. So that's why of the decrease. Keep decreasing. We're at 70%. Keep decreasing, 65%. And voiding is just at 10% now. Keep decreasing, 55% of neutron flux. Always checking things don't go too crazy here, and you see reactor level now is quite low, so I will wait a bit. Maybe it was decreasing too fast. Turbine temperatures have a differential of 20 degrees. We got the alarm here, low reactor level, but it was just at this point. It's catching back. Oh, I made a mistake. Okay, let's keep decreasing power. Let's keep decreasing, 40%. And let's assume the worker doesn't listen to us now, we will not give him clues. But if you expected the voiding to have a capital effect on reactivity now, you see that actually the rods are being slightly withdrawn from when we started the procedure. So it means we are gaining reactivity, even if we are drastically reducing voiding. Actually, there are several feedback loops. One is voiding, but there is also fuel temperature. So by reducing fuel temperature, you increase reactivity. So this may be significant in the reason why we are slightly gaining reactivity. So we'll keep decreasing power now, 35%, 30%. Generator load, we have to start looking at it because we don't want reverse polarity. Drum pressure is still high, but this is because we have a lot of accumulated pressure and because the control valve is in auto, so it's just keeping this pressure actually by closing the valve. So we should take care that the valve doesn't go close to zero. Let's keep decreasing power, 25%. And we know that below 25%, we only need one recirculation pump per loop. So here we have two per loop now connected. So I will decrease to 20%. At this point, we're at a voiding of 2% in both halves of the core. Rods have increased the position to 5.7. And now I will put offline the pump too. So offline, offline, close valve, and close valve. We get the message for the trip. Generated load is just 74 megawatts. Control valve at 70%. And rod position 5.7. Let's check the schematic. At this point, we only need one condenser circulating with a pump, so I will switch off the pump too. Okay, we get the message for the trip. And at this point we only need 2 feet water pump, so switch off the third one and close the discharge valve. Same for the condensate, we only need one pump out of the three. I can stop regenerating. Okay. Actually, I expected to lose some reactivity, so the ignorant worker actually may trigger no accident at all, but I really expected when we switch off the second recirculation pump to have an increased reactivity that, when we decrease the power, we decrease so much boiling that we lose controllability, but this is not the case. So what I will try to do now is to increase core flow or recirculation to see if we can lose controllability. But the boiling is quite low at 20% of power, so probably not. I'm checking the reactor rod positions. So still 5.7. I will connect the third pump, which is not normal to do at this power level, but just to see if we can decrease voiding to 1 or 0%. Not really. This is puzzling. Fuel is indeed cold compared to nominal, but not that cold. Okay, I will decrease power to 15% to see what happens and then go back to nominal. So as you see, if an ignorant worker comes from with a knowledge about this nuclear reactor, he could actually decrease power from nominal to 15%, even being at the edge of controllability without triggering a critical runaway or a stall or anything. So that's quite incredible. It seems the only thing that really triggers the doomsday here, it's pressing the AZ5 when you are in the edge of controllability, which is something so unlikely to happen. It only happens when you are, for this simulator, in a rod position between 4 and I think it's... yeah, it's something between 4 and 5. And I calculated the probability to be in this range was like 4% according to xenon concentration. So you see, it's no problem at all. So, okay, now the worker meets Dyatlov and he tells him, put this back to nominal power. So we will go back to nominal power, increasing 5 by 5. We're at 25. I already have the three pumps of the recirculation loops 1 and 2 on, so I will not bother to switch them off. 30%. And here the more critical for the speed of going back to nominal will be the reactor level. So let's check the red line here, and eventually some alarm telling high reactor level. 35%. And I should have connected the second condensate after 30 or 25. I do it now. And I realized because I saw the hot well level like stable but higher than normal, so it means it's spilling over because of the high level, I guess. That's fine. Reactor level going back to normal so we can keep increasing power. Turbine temperature still okay, vibration a bit high because of the differential expansion we see. It seems accelerating the turbine is much more critical than decelerating the turbine. Because in the deceleration I was like at 30 degrees differential and there was no vibration, and now I have vibration. So let's go to 50% power set point. So you see, the new worker went down to 15% power. And when he was told these reactors don't work like that, he quickly went back to nominal. But in the way down, we had 2 out of 3 MCPs per loop online. And now he forgot about this setting. And now we are going back using 3 out of 3 MCPs per loop. So we will have a low voiding. Let's see what happens. We're already at a rod position of 5.4%. Fuel temperature at 600 Celsius. So let's keep increasing power. Rod position on 5.4%. It just went to 1, but back to 2. Okay, 70% of power. Rod position 5.2. And now careful with the reactor level, it got a bit high. After 50%, I think I need the third feed pump. But the reactor level is so high that it's not really critical at this moment, I think, and hot well. Well, hot well seems to be high, so I will connect the third pump now. Okay, and open the discharge valve. That's good. Keep increasing power set point, let's go to 75%. Rod position is at 5.1%. Let's go to 80. Rod position is at 5%. And now we lost controllability. At the moment, rod position went to 5% and the power was at 90% power set point. We totally lost controllability. You see the neutron rate went down to like minus infinite. And very quickly, like in a negative exponential shape, the neutron flux decreased to a total stall of the reactor. Neutron flux is 2% now. Wait, there is a surge. There is a surge of the neutron rate. What happens? Okay, there is a scram. What happens is the reactor lost controllability. Trying to catch up the control of the reaction, it just started withdrawing rods. But it was already at the position of 4% of insertion, so withdrawing at this point didn't make much of an effect. And then I didn't see it, but probably because of the turbine tripped or some auxiliary tripped, we had a reactor scram, and the reactor scram caused this surge. So this is the very thing that caused the accident in Chernobyl 1986. Because we were so low in reactivity, the SARS could not bring the reactor up to a critical runaway and to an explosion. But you really saw the neutron rate going super high, like to plus infinite or at least out of scale. And the neutron flux went up. I did not see the number, you can rewind the video, but I think it went up like 5 or 10%. And then when the boron started to enter, I think I will end the video now. When the boron started to enter the... Well, no, I will plug the power supply. When the boron started to effectively decrease reactivity, we saw the effective decrease of neutron flux. So this was the first day of work of an inexperienced operator. You see how we almost reached the situation that already happened in Leningrad and Chernobyl. So at the beginning, I was not so confident because of the negative reactivity with fuel temperature counteracted the void, positive void. But at the end, because we cheat a bit and we connected the third pump in the increase to nominal, back to nominal power, we were able to recreate this scenario. I hope you like this video. See you in the next video. Bye.